Hello and welcome. You're watching The Buck Stops Here and I'm Barkha Dutt. The big political story, the BJP has gone on the offensive against the Congress leadership, Sonia Gandhi and Manmohan Singh included. This after an Italian court has basically described what it calls substantial disregard in arriving at the full truth behind what we've come to call the VVIP chopper scandal. That's of course a 2010 scam that was a 3,565 crore deal. The court order has also said that there is reasonable belief that corruption did take place in this particular scam, overturning a lower court order in Italy that said that there was no evidence of this corruption. Our sources are saying that in Parliament, the BJP will up the ante and target Sonia Gandhi herself. This after letters by middlemen describe the Congress president to be the driving force of the party and in fact lists several prominent advisers whom the firm and the middlemen are advised to target. Let's bring in our panel now on our face-off tonight. Nalin Kohli of the BJP is with us. Manish Tiwari of the Congress is with us as well. Nalin, in many ways, these letters of 2008 that are in front of us, where we are looking at what they say about Sonia Gandhi being the driving force, also the letter that speaks about how the Italian Prime Minister should call up Prime Minister Manmohan Singh, these have existed in the public domain now for a few years. Of course, what has changed is the conclusion that the Italian court has come to. Is the BJP now targeting the top leadership of the Congress? Because Meenakshi Lekhi today accused the Congress of trying to protect the Italian mafia. What did she mean?
Well, I mean, she's probably got something to say on that. You can ask her specifically what she meant. But let's come back to where we are in terms of the entire issue. A, this is not a court taking cognizance. This is a court that is delivering a conviction and sentencing two people to imprisonment for four and a half years, fining them about 9 million euros. That's almost about 50 crores plus. Basically, clearly, based on evidence, conclusively saying bribes were given to drive the deal.
Yes.
As simple as that.
Yes.
So the counter question becomes very important. Somebody took the bribes. So should not the bribe takers be convicted too? This can't be a one-way street. Now let's come to the order itself.
Yeah.
The order is a detailed order. I haven't read it. I'm told it will become available because media houses are working on its English translation.
Yes.
But somehow media houses like the Pioneer newspaper have even gone ahead and published part of it.
Yes.
In which they are in their report saying that Mrs. Sonia Gandhi is named at four places. And that's their report of today, which also points out, I think, at page 193 and 204. Now, the bottom line is that if that is true, and on the basis of that, if a conviction has taken place, it raises serious questions. And from the Congress perspective, one would expect that they make all the noises about corruption. They always say, their spokespersons are saying, we are the ones who said that, no, no, we'll blacklist the firm, etc., etc.
Right.
So simple, they should say, whoever took the bribes, we will demand, we in fact want that bribe takers should suffer the imprisonment because bribe givers have been convicted.
Manish Tiwari, that is a fair point, that if the bribe givers are in jail as they are in Italy, why should the bribed, why should the bribe takers be exempt? Now, this is a court verdict that does find that bribes were given, that there is reasonable belief that corruption did take place and there was substantial disregard, I'm quoting from the order, substantial disregard shown by the UPA in cooperating on this probe. Further, the references to Sonia Gandhi and Manmohan Singh are, of course, in the letters that are annexed as part of the annexures of this order. A 2008 letter that speaks of where middleman Christian Michel describes Sonia Gandhi to be the driving force behind the VIP helicopters. And then there's a 2013 letter from the former president of Augusta Westland, Orsi, who actually says, talks about the Italian prime minister and how he should pick up the phone and call Manmohan Singh. How is the Congress going to defend this politically?
Allow me to answer it straight off the bat. Let's rewind back to the year 2003. The decision to lower the height from 6,500 meters to 4,000 meters was a decision which was initiated by the then NDA government in the office of the Prime Minister. In fact, it is the principal secretary to the Prime Minister, late Mr. Brajesh Mishra, who had written a letter saying that the height needs to be brought down so that there can be a multiplicity of vendors. Otherwise, there had been only one vendor who had been shortlisted. As a consequence of that process, which got carried on into the term of the next government, you had the height brought down and a multiplicity of vendors came into the field. eventually, when the contract was signed and allegations surfaced with regard to certain aberrations, then it was the UPA government which went ahead and cancelled the contract. It was a UPA government which initiated multiple inquiries. It was a UPA government which went ahead and blacklisted the company in question. And now, here comes the interesting turn. The moment the BJP government comes into office, it revokes the blacklisting.
Okay.
It says that the company can go ahead and participate in all upcoming contracts. It says that its existing contracts can go on as usual. So therefore, the question would then be as to the onus really lies on whose foot. And now let me address the question with regard to the court.
Yeah.
A trial court came to a conclusion
that there,
was no evidence
yes.
of corruption.
Yes.
A higher court has come to a different conclusion. It's quite possible that a Supreme Court may come to a third conclusion altogether. So therefore, it's a process which is winding its way through the hierarchy of courts. You know, unfortunately, on the basis of conjecture, on the basis of malafide, on the basis
of
insinuation and half-truth,
yeah.
and a judgment which is not even there in the public domain, the Bharatiya Janata Party has been trying to make a song and dance out of it. I hope you've heard me in entirety.
I have. Because I can hear you interrupting in the middle, clear.
But I can't understand what you're saying.
All right. My question quite simply is, you have not answered what the letters suggest. The letters that speak about Sonia Gandhi as the driving force, written by a middleman to the regional head of Augusta Westland. This letter has been on file in 2008 and the court has chosen to make it part of the annexures of this verdict.
Well, as you rightly point out, that this particular document has been in the public domain. On the basis of the same document, a trial court came to a completely different conclusion altogether. So therefore, there is it is not as if, you know, some new ostensible evidence has emerged between the trial process and the matter going for appeal. In any case, the rules of jurisprudence across the world and natural justice are the same. Whatever material is available before the trial court, that's the material which can be agitated
okay.
before the High Court.
Okay.
And on the basis of this purported note, which allegedly, if I recall correctly, is possibly not even signed or it is not even authenticated, you know, you have certain people drawing a conjecture. And one thing which I've never been able to understand is that how come a court in a different jurisdiction, you know, without even giving anybody a chance to be heard, is actually passing sweeping obiter against them. I mean, this is a violation of the fundamental canons of natural justice. And so therefore, you know, I would like to rest my case by saying that what is happening today is really the theater of the absurd which is playing out. You don't even have a judgment in the public domain.
You have some excerpts
and certain conjectures. And on the basis of that, the Bharatiya Janata Party, in order to cover their own failures, has decided to make a song and dance out of it.
Manish, you made a very, very lengthy response and without answering the key political question. You've answered legally. There are political matters of perception here. There's a reference to Sonia Gandhi as a driving force. Yes, it's existed since 2008, but this court has chosen to obviously treat this material differently from the lower court. Nalin, though both of you are lawyers, Manish does make a valid legal point. He is saying tomorrow a higher court could come to a different conclusion, a lower court came to a different conclusion. Is the BJP, A, simply looking to deflect from many other controversies and this has landed in its lap? B, what about the fact that it was under the BJP that this particular company was actually taken off the blacklist and in fact asked to join the Make in India program?
I'll answer that. This may take a few minutes. I'll start with Mr. Manish Tiwari's last comment about the theater of the absurd. He puts that allegation on everyone else. There may be, there's a counter view to that, which applies equally to him. That his entire explanation may be also a theater of the absurd. Nevertheless, that's a matter of interpretation. Let's go back one by one. He spoke about the decision of the NDA government in 2003. Now, let me give a counter example. I want to buy a car. I decide to change the decision whether it's a car worth X lakhs or Y lakhs or, you know, whatever be the value. But the question is, in buying the car, did I take a bribe or pay a bribe? That's the question which is critical. And that's central. You have procurement, you'll have norms. You may change those norms. But the issue is, whose government is the bribe being spoken of? Not the NDA. Into the 10 long years of the UPA, the bribe question on which there's a conviction, that has happened clearly on the UPA. And whether it's political leadership or bureaucrats or whatever, that's what the ambit of it is. So you can't blame the decision of purchasing something. What is here which is malafide? Is the bribe being given and a bribe being taken? And there is a conviction on that. Number two, that it is the BJP that is removing the blacklist. Let me assume, I don't know for sure, but I'll take it on face value that yes, we have removed the blacklisting and said participate. So should we blacklist a company that is interested in punishing those who paid a bribe? Those who were involved in malafide intent in terms of securing orders from the government of India through a processes that were not recognized in law, which is bluntly putting it on the basis of corruption. So therefore, shouldn't you be, in a sense, working with companies who want to work in a clean manner? They don't want to work in a dirty manner, which may have been the process that they may have been forced to do also. How do we know for sure that this pressure was not on them, that you can't get an order till you pay a bribe to X number of political people? And in this case, the court order, as per the Pioneer newspaper's report, points to the very top leadership of the Congress party, which is Mrs. Sonia Gandhi. Now let's come to the next issue.
Yeah.
Manish Tiwari makes a very big thing about, oh, let's go about the lower court, upper court. Sure. Of course, the legal rights remain the same across the world. Those who are convicted will have a right to go to the next court. I don't know what it is in the in Italy. In India, it will be based on a law point, not a matter of fact. But the evidence and all the arguments, all the pleadings are now sealed. They are part of the court record, which will undoubtedly be part of whatever happens thereafter. So if I now believe, he says that till somebody participates, their name is there.
Yeah.
A bribe being given or a bribe being taken is a matter of fact based on evidence. This is not a court judge just sitting down there and dictating the name of somebody he likes or he doesn't like. So therefore, if they want to be a party, they need to answer two things. They have no faith on the, they can say, it's their right. They can say, the Congress party in a statement tomorrow can say, we have zero faith in the courts of Italy. We denounce the judgment. They are free to say that. They are free to say that we do not believe that Italy has a system that is sound and robust to have done an investigation and a conviction on the basis of sound legal principles. They can say that if they wish. But the point comes out is, during the period when which the court was trying, they sought from the government of India help. They said, get involved in it.
So you are,
according to the newspaper reports, it took 1 year from 2013 to 2014 for the UPA Congress government to send four documents. The question being asked is, did the government of India didn't want the truth? And now that the names have come out, the fingers will point, unfortunately, in a very, very negative fashion to
the Congress. So you are saying, before I get Manish to respond to that, you are saying that Sonia Gandhi and Manmohan Singh are personally now answerable, now that these letters by these middlemen have become part of court record, not simply placed as charges by the prosecution, but attached to the verdict of the court. Am I correct in that being your position, Nalin?
Well, I mean, that's a fair point, but I'll just take it on one step further. In fairness, they have the legal rights available to every citizen. If they want to challenge that and they want to participate, they want to denounce it, they are in their rights to do so. But the question is, this is out of a court conviction. This is not a leak, a WikiLeaks. This is not a question of something coming out of, you know, an expose, an investigation
Fair
by
enough.
Journalism.
Fair enough.
It's something based on a proper due legal process.
Let Manish respond.
Oh, your last point. You asked me whether we are trying to milk it politically and trying to deflect attention.
I'm saying that
look,
would
the
be
political
one argument,
process.
But that's what politicians
political
do on
process,
both sides.
The political process.
Yeah, that's what politicians do on both sides. That doesn't change the substance of the issue. I agree with that. Manish Tiwari, the fact is, the problem for the Congress right now is not the legal argument. The problem for the Congress right now is the political argument. The fact that a Meenakshi Lekhi gets up in Parliament and says, was the UPA trying to protect the Italian mafia? The fact that now these letters that speak about the Italian Prime Minister and how he should reach out to Manmohan Singh, Sonia Gandhi described as the driving force behind these VIP helicopters, listing, you know, advisors that include a whole bunch of people from, you know, M.K. Narayan to other people, not just Congress leaders, but bureaucrats of the time as well. How will you tackle this politically? What will be your response in Parliament tomorrow? Or will you just not let Parliament function?
Well, let me answer that straight off the bat. First of all, I find it rather rich coming from Mr. Nalin Kohli, whose president, Mr. Bangaru Lakshman, the late Bangaru Lakshman, was actually caught with his hand in the till, taking 1 lakh rupees, just a lakh of rupees, you know, for fictitious arms deals, you know, in his office. So therefore, you know, when the BJP lectures about morality, that picture of Bangaru Lakshman actually, you know, putting his hand into the till and taking that cash refreshes in my mind. Number two, this is the same campaign of calumny which these people carried out from 1988 all the way up to 2004. And in 2004, when the Delhi High Court in the February of 2004, when there was an NDA government in office, ruled that there was not a shred of evidence against all the people that they were accusing in Bofors, this government, which Mr. Nalin Kohli represents, did not even have the temerity, did not even have the gumption to go and file a special leave petition in the Supreme Court, because they knew that the Supreme Court is going to throw them out. The High Court verdict is so watertight. Number three, coming to, you know, this grand lecture which Mr. Kohli has delivered about, you know, guilt or otherwise, the fact of the matter is, what are you basing this conjecture on? Ostensibly on a piece of paper which has not been authenticated.
Manish, how is it conjecture? Manish, how is it conjecture?
Barkha, allow me to.
No, I'm just asking. How is it conjecture? It's an order. It's a court order.
A court order which can be overturned tomorrow. A court order which nobody has seen till today.
I must answer.
A court order which has not emerged in the public domain.
No, the court order is accessible. So what are you having? You are having a political 300 pages of Italian, so it has to be translated meticulously. Manish, the larger narrative is not in doubt.
Has Mr. Nalin Kohli read the order? There is no order in the public domain as we speak.
Manish, listen to me.
Nalin, please do not interrupt. I heard you very patiently. Do not interrupt. Allow me to complete. So what are you having today? You know, it's nothing else but an orchestrated witch hunt based upon an order nobody has read, an order which has not emerged in the public domain, at least in a language which is legible to me. It may be very well legible to Mr. Nalin Kohli or the people who believe in driving this agenda. So ultimately, you know, you have a situation whereby a lower court came to a entirely different conclusion on the same set of facts. But you have a high court which has come to a conclusion. But you have a high court which has come to a conclusion,
Manish,
and that high court order
has been
overturned.
Manish, this page, this paper in front of me is a page from the order. I'm holding it up for you. I'm trying to say this is not conjecture. This is an order. Yes, it is in Italian. It is being translated because it's 225 pages. But these are pages that talk about Manmohan Singh, Sonia Gandhi, and other top Congress leaders, and the letters that were written about them by middlemen. What the BJP is saying is, if these people who gave bribes are in jail, what about the bribe takers? And I think that's a valid question. And this is not conjecture.
Barkha, at the end of the day, somebody has decided, you know, to cherry pick from an order which is not even there in the public domain and spin a story.
Okay, let me get
that. Therefore, every legal order. Has to be read in a certain context.
Okay, I have to get a last word from
tomorrow.
I'm out of time.
Tomorrow, when the 245-page order really emerges, may find that the context is absolutely different.
Nalin, last word.
So that's why I'm saying just an orchestrated witch hunt and nothing more than that.
Okay, orchestrated witch hunt. Nalin, last word.
There were some personal comments. I'll have to return it in the same vein. But let me first go at this. Yes, Mr. Bangaru Lakshman was convicted, and of course he enjoyed due legal process. But he was convicted. He went to jail. The late Mr. Bangaru Lakshman. So would Manish have the guts to say that I don't mind my Congress president, whoever the Congress president is or whoever the Congress leader is, convicted should go to jail. We want the...
I didn't interrupt.
Let me finish. No, you rebut at the end.
Okay, last word I have to close.
No, second point.
Yeah.
Second point I'm saying is he's called it a piece of conjecture.
Yeah.
So I presume by the same standards, as an advocate, he believes that the Uttarakhand High Court and the single judge are just pieces of conjecture. Because after all, it's before the Supreme Court. I don't think that's how the legal process runs. And last, no, let me finish. Manish, that's the third time you interrupted me. I'm not interrupted you. I must finish my third point. My third point is, may I finish my third point, please? Manish, you can't shout me down.
I really have to close, guys. I have to close. Nalin, make your last point, 15 seconds, please.
My last sentence, which is very simple. If you believe, I think Mr. Tiwari can very simply say the Congress wants to absolutely participate and ensure that the truth comes out. And the Congress party wants, it will apply for a certified copy of this. The BJP has no talent to translate Italian into English, but the Congress party may have good talent in-house to be able to help in translating it so that the good truth comes out.
You've been in office for 2 years now. You've even unblacklisted the blacklisted firms.
Okay,
you've allowed business to go on as usual. And here you are lecturing us about morality.
Nalin, we leave this for Parliament tomorrow. We leave it for Parliament tomorrow, though my sense is Parliament will not work.
To run its natural course.
Okay, Manish Tiwari, Nalin Kohli, leaving it there. This is going to spill over into Parliament, though my suspicion is Parliament is not going to function. Yet this is a debate that's not going away anywhere as more details of this order emerge. Thank you, Manish. Thank you, Nalin. All right, we're taking a quick break. On the other side, our special ground series from Bengal, where we look at the state's politics through the lens of food. Politics on a Plate is up next. Stops here, coming to you from the heart of Bengal. We're in Bhavanipur, the Chief Minister's constituency, in Jaggu Market. And as you can see everywhere, where there's Bengal, there's fish. This is, of course, a fish and a meat market. No Bengali can do without their fish. And on these two episodes, we are actually taking you on a gastronomic journey of Bengal. Why are we doing this in election season? Well, because we're looking at the state's politics through its food. We're literally eating our way through Bengal. And let's talk to a few people here. Sir, can you tell us a little bit ye bazaar ke bare mein ye kitna purana hai?
100 saal ke upar.
100 saal se upar.
Upar 100 saal ke upar hoga. Ha. Ha, ye bazaar mein matlab medieval people ke liye very good.
Acha. Aur 100 saal se purana bazaar hai aur yahan fish bhi milta hai aur meat bhi.
Sab fish meat sab milta hai.
अच्छा ये बताइए मुझे चुनाव में क्या होने वाला है?
ये तो ममता जी आने वाली है लेकिन मार्जिन थोड़ा कम हो जाएगा.
तो मतलब लेफ्ट और कांग्रेस के इकट्ठे आने से उसकी फाइट थोड़ी टफ होगी.
थोड़ा फाइट होगा. हाँ. फाइट होगा लेकिन ममता जी आएगी.
अच्छा आपको क्या लगता है चुनाव में क्या होने वाला है?
चुनाव में यहाँ पर दीदी का एरिया है, दीदी ही जीतेगी.
अच्छा ये कह रहे हैं मार्जिन थोड़ा कम हो जाएगा लेफ्ट और कांग्रेस.
कम होगा ही लेकिन दीदी का एरिया दीदी ही जीतेगी.
अच्छा अच्छा ये बाजार के बारे में इन्होंने बोला कि 100 साल से पुराना है. यहाँ कौन कौन लोग आते हैं?
यहाँ सब तरह के लोग आते हैं. सब तरह के घर, बड़े बड़े घर से छोटे मोटे घर, सब तरह.
और हर तरह का फिश और हर तरह का
सामान आपको यहाँ मिलेगा. चूल से लेकर नोक तक सब कुछ मिलेगा.
A to Z. आप क्या कहेंगे चुनाव में क्या होने वाला है?
चुनाव में क्या होने वाला है? ऊपर वाला जानता है.
ऊपर वाला जानता है. Well, some people are willing to take a bet on the election. Some people say ऊपर वाला जानता है. But one thing they're all agreed on, A to Z, इस बाजार में सब कुछ मिलता है.
লুটি ছোট ছুটি টালি থেকে টালা ওল ঢোল এগ রোল বেলফুল মালা লেনিনের পাদ দেশ প্রণামীর থালা তবু পরি ঘোর ভিক্টোরিয়া যাক উড়ে যাক দুধে ভাতে থাক কলকাতা কলকাতা দেই আমার শহর আমার শহর আমার শহর আমার শহর আমার শহর
On the streets of Kolkata, Mamata Banerjee's answer to the first ever alliance between the left and the Congress is war by video clips.
बंगाल में रोजगार नहीं मिल सकता, ममता जी की सरकार रोजगार नहीं ला सकती बंगाल में।
आमी तो बांग्लाटा चीनी ना क्या ना सीपीएम साथ घर करते हैं कांग्रेस के और कांग्रेस नेताराओ बोल आई तब सहचरी।
The Trinamool is using the excerpts of Rahul Gandhi's speeches to underline the Congress contradiction. No love lost for the left in Kerala and an arranged marriage in Bengal. But the Jot, as the partnership is called, is banking on the Bihar model in the belief that arithmetic can deliver what chemistry may lack. In 2014, the Congress plus left vote was 39.6%, just marginally less than the 39.79% in the Trinamool's kitty. Translating vote share into seats is a different battle altogether. And we take that question to Deepa Das Munshi, the Congress leader tasked with the impossible job of playing challenger to Mamata Banerjee. We meet her early morning over kachori and alu ki sabzi at Sharma Tea Shop, a store famous for its kesar chai.
Well, we are right now at the Sharma Tea House with Deepa Das Munshi. We're of course in Bhavanipur. She is one of the candidates here, and this is as we can see here, kachori and aloo, early morning breakfast here. Also, this place, if the camera can come here, is famous for its kesar chai. Let's talk to Deepa Das Munshi over kachori, aloo, and kesar chai. Deepa ji, we are in Mamata Banerjee's stronghold. This is where you're contesting against her. A lot of people will feel that you've been given an impossible battle, an impossible task. What would you say to that?
Look, definitely initially people were thinking that it's an impossible task. But gradually what we have seen, there are a lot of problems in this constituency where normally we find the Chief Minister's constituency is almost like a lot of work has been done, a lot of development has been done. But it's very unfortunate that here in Bhavanipur, there are tremendous, tremendous scarcity of water, and people are jobless. What they thought 5 years back, that what aspiration they had, now it is totally, totally a disaster. And moreover, the way she behaves, she never talks with people, she never meets people, and the corruption, which is the corruption charges, which has come on TMC Congress, that has made a lot of difference.
But would you have preferred to contest from another constituency where your chances were better?
Yeah, definitely my chances were definitely better. People were asking from North Bengal, where I was.
Exactly, that was your base. So would you have preferred contesting from there?
No, I didn't want to come in the assembly election. But when party decided, when people decided, and I came to Bhavanipur first, I talked to the people. And they said, we don't want this government anymore. So we want a change. And that's why I took it as a challenge. I took it as a voice of the people who are speechless in Bhavanipur because no one is allowed to speak against Mamata Banerjee.
Do you believe you have any chance?
Yes.
You actually believe that, or you're saying that just for the cameras?
No, you have seen I'm so casual, I'm so, I'm not, now, I no tension I'm having, and is not in front of camera, but it's my conviction.
Tell me, ma'am, the alliance between your party and the left, that has caused a lot of questions, because on the one hand in Kerala you have Rahul Gandhi attacking the left, here Rahul Gandhi is asking the left and the Congress to come together. How do you explain this contradiction or this alliance of convenience?
Look, in Kerala there is no Mamata Banerjee. In Kerala there is no such corruption which Mamata Banerjee had in from Sharda to Narda, what we have seen. Here people wanted that all the opposition who are democratic, people wanted the opposition as a democratic front, people wanted opposition as a secular front should all come together. And so it is not only the left and Congress, there are other forces, even the non-political forces, they have also come and joined under the same umbrella. So it is therefore an alliance of people. It's not that all of a sudden Rahul Gandhi said and Ye Churi they met and they had a chit chat and they decided that there will be an alliance in Bengal. So it is not like that. It is the people's aspiration, people wanted it, that's why it's how we have come together.
What the coming together of the left and the Congress has done is to displace the BJP. The Modi effect in 2014 had delivered a 17% vote share to the party. But if Bengal was to be the next bastion to storm, the alliance has halted the saffron rise. Ironically, Mamata Banerjee would probably want more of the anti-Trinamool vote to go to the BJP rather than the left and the Congress, thereby splitting the vote against her. We take the prospects of the BJP to one of its only two MPs in the state, musician Babul Supriyo. Our culinary journey that is looking at Bengal's politics through its food has now brought us to one of South Kolkata's most favorite restaurants, Bhojohori Manna, named after a cult Manna Day song. In fact, the legendary musician has even eaten here. Some of Bengal's big culture names are associated with this chain of restaurants. Gautam Ghosh, the famous film director, and then of course Topshe, who remains one of the most beloved on-screen characters for West Bengal in, of course, the Satyajit Ray series, Feluda. It is here that we are going to find out why, apart from all the other election issues, even fish, in particular the Hilsa, can be the source of political battle. So what do you get when National Award director Gautam Ghosh and the boy who played Topshe in the cult Satyajit Ray series Feluda come together to form a restaurant? Well, you get Bhojohori Manna, and that's where we are. And since it's inspired by a cult Manna Day song, we thought this is the best place to meet musician turned politician and minister Babul Supriyo. And of course, there are here a group of young musicians as well. So this is the intersection of music and food. But first, let's get a few comments from one of the owners of the restaurant, Siddharth Chatterjee. You were 14 and a half years old when you played Topshe. You're in your mid-50s now. In many ways, this restaurant is all about nostalgia and maybe a little bit of your own journey as well. Tell us about this restaurant.
First of all, thank you for coming here. Well, it was 14 years. I was just a kid when I did my first film, Shonar Kedla. And then I was a bit of a foodie myself all across this 14 to 55 now. And 12, 13 years back, we had this idea of starting a restaurant. And we didn't have any experience about what how food is made, no hotel experience. Yeah. No. So we thought that what we understand, that what we eat and what we like, if that can be showcased as a restaurant food.
Now, I want you to come here with me and just play for us what you were playing, and Siddharth can tell us a history of this song and what it's named after.
One, two, three, four. La 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 la. La 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 la. La 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 la.
So I just want you to tell us about this song for people who are not Bengali.
Okay.
Ami Sri Sri Bhojohori Manna, okay. Sung by Manna Day, cult status. Tell us a little more.
You see, it all happened, I believe Manna Day sang this song for a film called Pratham Kadam Phool. And that was a huge hit. This is all about a cook who went all throughout the world, in various places, picked up some kind of culinary expertise, and then came to back Kolkata and then started serving the food he understood. And that's why, and his name is Bhojohori Manna.
We'll come to the song, but I want to discuss a little bit of politics and elections, because after all, it is election season. Babul, in this election, many people would say that the BJP is fighting a losing battle, that you're isolated, that in the Lok Sabha elections, actually, the BJP did really well in terms of the percentage of vote share. You had about 17% vote share. But this time, you actually have the real fight between Mamata Di and the left and the Congress. Where is the BJP in this?
Well, that is, today in today's world, perception is considered to be reality. And the media has actually portrayed this entire fight into a fight between the left and Congress jot, the coalition. And I think that it's very arrogant and premature and non-democratic to go ahead and announce that we are the winners and we are going to rule.
No, but I'm not announcing the winners. I'm just saying that the real contest, the game has changed with the left and the Congress reaching an understanding. Would you agree that that has made your job a lot more difficult? Because in the earlier election, a lot of the votes that were going away from the left were either going to, you know, Mamata or they were going to the BJP. Now you have the left and the Congress coming together. Has this not created an election where you don't have a winning chance at all?
Well, no. I wouldn't say we don't have a winning chance at all. I am not going to say that. But let me tell you that mathematically, if there is 100 rupees and you have A and B sharing that, then there is a chance that you might get 50-50. Hmm. The moment you have A, B and C, the mathematically the equation does change. And Congress and CPIM are no newcomers, right? So when they come into the foray, the equation has to change. Now, what that does to the actual mathematics of for the 19th of May is something to be seen. It's like a khichri here. Hmm. Now, this is bar and kha. Kha in Bengali means eat. So it's bar kha. So as you eat, I'll tell you the khichri that is right now being pakaud in Bengal with every segment coming into the play.
We will talk politics in just a second, but I've got very distracted because there's too much food on the table. What is this?
What I'm doing is, see, this is the caviar. This is ilish mach at deem. So I take this out, and in the ilish mach, this is ilish mach, which is absolutely attached with Bengali sentiments. And Bengal is actually reeling under the pressure of Bangladesh not agreeing to export ilish to Bengal.
Ilish is hilsa.
Yes, it is because of the Teesta crisis. So we are reeling for not getting this ilish, and it is also associated with the sports in Bengal. It's ilish match for East Bengal and chingri match for Mohun Bagan.
So I'm going to get Siddharth to explain that to us. So are you saying, Siddharth, that in a state like Bengal, even the fish is political?
Yeah, hilsa is the queen of fish, and it's primarily produced in the rivers of Bangladesh. There's a kind of a water sharing problem with the government of India.
Yeah.
Now, while they're fighting...
With Bangladesh.
Yeah. Government of India and Bangladesh. Because we are not releasing a lot of water, that's their claim.
Yes.
Now, that is not the issue. The issue is, because of the partition, the people from East Bengal, now Bangladesh, had come and settled in West Bengal. And the West Bengal people were there originally.
Yeah.
They used to love prawn.
This is...
It's called chigiri mach.
This one. Yeah.
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 Okay?
Yeah.
And the people who came from Bangladesh, that's why... Undivided Bengal, they always liked hilsa. So when they migrated here, the basic fight and till date on the issue of hilsa and the issue of chigri, which is prawn, there can be debates.
And you're saying that there are fights, there are duels that happen between the chingri and the ilish?
East Bengal and Mohun Bagan is the derby. That's the derby match.
This is how a hilsa looks.
And this is the hilsa that you're saying is a deep political issue here.
Big time political issue is this particular fish.
So you guys are saying that around this fish is not just the tension between India and Bangladesh, but also the football politics is also being played out.
Yeah.
And this hilsa represents that fault line.
Well, if Mohun Bagan loses, even if I love hilsa, I am not going to buy that. And if East Bengal loses, The East Bengal supporters are not going to buy the prawn in spite of them wanting to have chingri mach and malai curry, which is a real delicacy in Kolkata.
Okay, now I want to come back to the politics. You don't think that because in the previous state elections, the Prime Minister has campaigned so extensively and made himself the face of the campaign, that when there is a defeat, then because if there's a victory, you'll see a Modi ji ki victory. Yeah? So if there's a defeat also, then it reflects on him. That's what people say is the danger with getting him involved in these campaigns.
Well, I think we have a very courageous leader. I mean, we have to see the flip side as well, a very courageous leader who leads from the front and actually inspires people. You have to see Modi ji's, his meetings, public meetings, to see how much euphoria it generates. People who are actually fighting the fight on the streets need to see their leader.
But in Bihar also, he got big crowds. It has to translate into votes. I know that musicians generally like to talk only about music, but I'm just wondering if anyone has, any questions. You have a question?
What has inspired him to come to this politics from his musical career? What has inspired him?
I did not...
Yeah, go ahead.
I did not shift from one place to the other. I'm telling you. What a charger is to your mobile, music is to me. But I think that in every situation, there is some kind of a ray of light, something that your luck or destiny wants to test you. Baba Ramdev suddenly sitting beside me on a flight, talking politics, understanding.
But Baba Ramdev is also the same person who said that if you don't say Bharat Mata, those who don't say Bharat Mata ki jai, you know, if the law didn't stop it, we would cut off their heads. So, I mean, is that really the reason that you should give to as your inspiration for joining?
Barkha, let me complete. What I'm saying is that Baba Ramdev might be having his own opinions.
Do you support those opinions? No, do you support this kind of language?
No, I don't support that language. But having said that, I would not, because he has been instrumental. Sometimes when you talk about your own gurus, when they do mistakes, you just keep quiet. If you think that's a mistake, you do not say anything. You just keep quiet. I want to be decent in that. I just want to tell him to answer his question. He sat beside me. I felt that on air, there was something probably jhilke us paar kya kuch kahani rakhi hui hai. So I took the challenge that, you know, BJP, he said BJP doesn't have that strength in Bengal. I said, Dada, sir, aap isme ek naam likh lijiye. Agar aap mera naam likh loge, dekho mera haath, main haar nahi sakta hun. So I took that challenge. Suddenly, it was not a well thought process, but I did it. After 1 week, he called me up and said, ki tum bada mazedar laga, natkat laga. Sach mein bola tha kya? I said, sir, joke is a very serious thing. Charlie Chaplin.
You had this conversation with Baba Ramdev.
Absolutely.
So Baba Ramdev is the reason that you're in politics?
No. He's not.
Baba Ramdev is the one who carried back the message to the BJP.
He's not the reason. I think if I have done good in the last 2 years.
No, he's the one who brought you into politics.
No. No one brought me to politics. I brought myself to politics.
You had this conversation with Baba Ramdev and he told the BJP.
Yes, exactly. And he found it is his credit that he found a small politician in me. If people agree that I've done good in the last 2 years, I will give credit to him because he took me seriously.
So let me tell you that there's a line, as you know, ye public hai, ye sab janti hai. So that's going to be decided here. But I can see the guitarist is already picking up the strains of that. Let's end with actually the song that this restaurant is inspired by.
Ami Shishi Bhajo Holi Manna Istanbul giye Japan Kabul giye shikhechi notun ei ranna Ami Shishi Bhajo Holi Manna Ami Shishi Bhajo Holi Manna Hate niye dekhchi jei tuli hechi ki biryani korma potoler dorma mile mishe hoye jay Pariser chechki পাবেন না মশলাটা যেখানেই যান না আমি শিশি ভজহরি মান্নাম সুইজারল্যান্ড গিয়ে ইজিপ্ট হল্যান্ড গিয়ে শিখেছি নতুন রান্না আমি শিশি ভজহরি মান্না ও হো আমি শিশি ভজহরি মান্না আরে আমি শিশি ভজহরি মান্না ইয়ে পাবলিক হ্যায় ये सब जानती है
Don't forget that. Ye public hai, sab jaanti hai.
Yes, therefore, I don't want Trinamool Congress and CPIM to forget that people will always remember what they did in 4.5 years and what Trinamool CPIM
Ye public hai, sab jaanti hai.
What CPIM did in CPIM did in 34 years and what Congress did to the entire country
song,
in
song,
10 years.
Song is more effective than speeches. Okay, we'll leave it there. Overloaded with food, we think we will not eat a morsel more. But in a few hours, as the sun sets over the Victoria Memorial, the Tongas trot out and the Jhalmuri Walas get ready. We know our day will not be complete without what Calcuttans love most, fuchkas. And the fuchkas literally stop here at Vivekanand Park. Of course, no conversation about Bengal's food or its politics is complete without a puchka. This one's a bit too big to pop in at one go. But we're here right outside Vivekanand Park where Jitender and Meena Pandit, originally from Bhagalpur, run this very, very famous puchka stall. I've just had a dahi puchka, but there are many different kinds of puchkas. And we're here to do our own version, our Bengali version of Chai Pe Charcha, which is puchka and politics. And abhi khate hain, there are lots of people here, cross-section of Kolkata society, all, of course, busy eating. Sabko khilaiye na, Jitendra bhai. Aap to, aapka vote to yahi dalta hai na, aap to?
Haan, hum yahi dalte hai vote.
Kya lagta hai, chunav mein kya hoga?
Chunav mein to abhi to didi ka hi raaj chal raha hai.
Didi ka raaj chal raha hai.
So Jitendra Pandit thinks that Didi ka raag chal raha hai. But let's hear from other people. Please don't let me stop you from eating puchkas. What do you think? What's your take on this entire election and the way the campaign is going? Is it a foregone conclusion, as some suggest? Or is it really too early to call?
Well, in some ways it is a foregone conclusion. But, before the last assembly elections, we were all looking for change. Mm-hmm. And we'd hoped for a change for the better. But the last 5 years have been quite disappointing. And for someone like me who works on women's rights issues, it's been rather alarming.
What alarms you in particular?
The fact that a lot of politics is made, a lot of partisanship of violence against women. And there's a lot of drama around the issue. But very few efforts have been made to address the issue from our women's network. We've tried to meet the minister, but we haven't been very successful.
Let me see if other people agree. What do you think? There's a disappointment that you have a woman chief minister, but you have a view here that maybe not enough has been done. What do you think?
Well, I kind of agree that the women's issues have not been taken up, because in the last few years we've seen a lot of violence against women. A lot of issues have come up in colleges as well. But I think if that's only one area, there's a lot more where a lot of development has happened. So if I look at the city per se, and having lived in other cities, I think so much has happened in the last few years, which I think is a Trump.
I agree with her. I've come back from Mumbai 2 years back. And when I left the city, I didn't want to stay in the city anymore, because really a dying city. And when I got back, I'm an entrepreneur. I make around 2-3 lakh jute bags every month. And I love the city because it's growing on me now. I'm doing very well. So I think there's place for everyone. I wouldn't say if you are a woman, there are things happening in the city which is alarming. But there's growth also. So a mixed bag,
really. आपसे पूछते हैं, पुचका खा के जाइए मत, थोड़ा हमारे से भी बातचीत करिए. क्या लगता है, आप लोग सब यहीं के हैं, क्या लगता है कि चुनाव में क्या होने जा रहे हैं?
I think it's Didi is coming back.
Didi is coming back.
Yeah, I think so.
What do you think? So a lot of people think Didi is coming back, but some people have concerns about different issues on and her track record. What do you think? Do you believe that the main contest has now become between the Congress Left Alliance and Mamata Banerjee? Do you feel there's any space for the BJP in this at all?
Absolutely. I think BJP should be given a chance, because Bengal has tasted 30 years of Congress rule, which was very bad. And thereafter, consecutive 35 years of CPM, which just led us into the doldrums. Now, I think BJP, the Narendra Modi government, according to the youth, I feel is doing a good job.
But who's the face of the BJP here? Isn't that a problem? Who's the face of the BJP? Like in Mamata Banerjee, you have a clear face.
Is just one particular leader, one face, so important? I mean, do we have to have a Rahul Gandhi or a Sonia Gandhi and the rest don't work? I think BJP should be given a chance.
Let me get other views in. So he's saying a face is not all that matters. You're a young voter. What do you think?
I think that this time in the elections, I guess it will be like, not in this elections, but the other consecutive elections, it will be Didi for a decade, I guess, because...
Didi for a decade, and yeah, he's saying give BJP a chance. Let me go here, you wanted to come in.
I told you that maybe Didi is coming, but personally I think that there should be a change and BJP should be given a chance. Because we really need a change at this moment of time.
Now, one of the interesting things, of course, is that Mamata Banerjee's popularity is much deeper in rural Bengal, and in urban centers we hear more voices like yours. But you've got somebody saying give BJP a chance. You've got somebody saying it's actually going to be Didi, Didi for a decade.
See, I really want to speak about what happened the few days ago when a presidency student, she was smoking and she was wearing shorts. So. An old man, he abused her and assaulted her. So that's really disappointing, because we girls don't feel safe here. Even now...
You don't feel safe?
We don't feel safe. Yeah, even now when...
But there are reports that actually suggest that Kolkata is among, the safer metros than they've actually been awarded for that.
Yes, safer than Delhi, obviously, for sure. But
we can hear...
So that's Delhi. Your major concern.
Yes.
Your major concern is that, and that feeds into a little bit of what you were saying. What do you think? How are you seeing the campaign?
I'm seeing that there's no real face which we have. So I think she would continue for
another 5-10 years.
Because she's the one most prominent face.
She's the most prominent face, yes.
Now, all of you have spoken. You've spoken about Mamta, you've spoken about Modi, but you've not spoken about the left and the Congress at all. I haven't heard conversations about the left and the Congress. So do you want to come in on...
This is just an alliance of convenience. In Kerala, they will oppose each other. Here, they will... It's just... Politics makes...
Has it made Mamta's fight tougher?
Some people are saying it's made it tougher, but I find that this alliance very hard to come to terms with, because these are two parties who've always been at loggerheads.
Well, the left has supported the UPA at the center earlier too.
Yes, but in Bengal, the thought of the CPM and the Congress aligning, I mean, we are saying the left front, but it's basically the CPM and the Congress. And that's very, very hard to come to terms with. It also shows you that it's an alliance of convenience. But it's for someone like me, it is alarming because lately, we've had all these instances of moral policing. And to hear young people saying that they'd like the BJP here, I'm worried.
No, but if you look at the Congress and Left Alliance, where have they been in the last 5 years? They've just come up now. So it is for convenience.
But this is a state where the left had entrenched rule for more than 3 decades, and Mamata Banerjee goes and changes all that. Do you believe that with this alliance, aapko kya lagta hai? Kya lag raha hai chunav mein? Jo left aur Congress ka samjhota hai, isse kuch badal sakta hai?
Ekdam badalna.
Aap badlenge? Aap kiske samarthak hai?
बस अपना एक ही है पार्टी, अभी तो तृणमूल ही है। और
आप तृणमूल कह रहे हैं, लेकिन आप कह रहे हैं लेफ्ट और कांग्रेस के अलायंस से असर पड़ेगा?
असर तो पड़ेगा ही, थोड़ा बहुत पड़ेगा ही, लेकिन फिर भी तृणमूल ही को ही आना है अभी।
सो एटलीस्ट फ्रॉम दिस पुचका स्टॉल, the verdict very much seems to be that it's advantage Mamata Banerjee.
आमी शिशि भजो होली मन्ना, इस्तांबुल गिए जापान काबुल गिए, শিখেছি নতুন রান্না, আমি শিশি ভজহরি মান্না, আমি শিশি ভজহরি মান্না, হাতে নিয়ে দেখছি সেই তুলি হেঁচি কি বিরিয়ানি করমা পটলের দরমা, মিলেমিশে হয়ে যায় প্যারিসের ছেচকি, পাবেন না মশলাটা যেখানেই যান না, আমি শিশি ভজহরি মান্না। সুইজারল্যান্ড গিয়ে, ইজিপ্ট, হল্যান্ড গিয়ে শিখেছি নতুন রান্না, আমি শিশি ভজহরি মান্না। ও হো।